This video is going to be about subsets and proper subsets. So here's what we're talking about. Let's say I start out with set A, and set A contains the elements A, B, C, and D. And I also have set B, and set B contains the elements A, C, and D. Now, since all of the elements in B are also found in A, I can say that B is a subset of A. And I'll write that like this. B is a subset of A. And I'll use the subset symbol, which is like a sideways U facing towards the A, and a bar underneath it. Okay? The A, by the way, is called the superset. It's the superset of B. Okay. Now, let's say I add another set. Let's say I have set C. And set C contains the elements D, C, B, and A. Well, all of the elements in set C are also found in set A. So I can say that set C is a subset of set A. Set C also has exactly the same elements as set A. In other words, sets A and C are equal to each other. So equal sets can be considered as subsets. One would be the subset of the other. Since they're equal, it wouldn't matter what order you put them in. So to be a subset, a set has to have all of its elements found, or all of its elements must be elements of another set, its superset. They can be exactly the same elements, or they can be just some of the elements that are in the superset. Now, if they don't have all of the elements that you find in the superset, then we can say that it's a proper subset. In other words, set B is a proper subset of set A because set B has less elements than set A. And we write the symbol for the proper subset is just going to be a sideways U without a bar underneath. So once again, the distinction is this. Anytime the elements of one set, all of the elements of one set, are found in another set, we can say that that first set is a subset of the other one. So set B is a subset of set A, and set C is a subset of set A. If you've got a set that is a subset, but also has less elements than the other set, than the superset, then we can say that it's a proper subset. So proper subsets have less elements than their superset. Okay? Now, sometimes you may be asked to determine how many possible subsets a set could have. And here's how we're going to do that. Let's say I start out with a very simple set. Let's say I start out with set A, and the only element in set A is a small a. So I'm going to consider two possibilities. Either I've got another set with an A in it, in which case that's a subset of set A, or I've got an empty set. Now, an empty set has no elements, and so all of its elements are also in set A. So I'm going to start making a table. I'm going to consider what happens if I've got that set with just the A in it. If the A is present, I'm going to write a 1. And if the A is absent, I'll write a 0. And now let's say I expand that set. Let's say I make that into a set with two elements, A and B. Now consider this possibility, or these possibilities. If I have a subset and the A was in it, then I might have a B in it also, or I might not. If I have a subset and there was no A in it, I might still have a B in it, or I might not. And so I went from two subsets when there was just an A to four subsets when I have an A and a B as possible elements. If I add a third element, C, then for each of those possibilities that I had when there were only two elements, I've got two more possibilities. So if there's an A and a B, I might have a C, I might not have a C. If there's an A but no B, I might have a C, I might not have a C. If I've got no A, but I've got a B, I might have a C, I might not have a C. If I've got no A and no B, I might have a C, and I might not have a C. So now I've got eight possibilities. So what's happening is, each time I add a letter, I double the number of possible subsets. A simple way to say this is that I can take the number 2 and raise it to the power, which is the number of elements in the set. In other words, I could raise it to the cardinality of the set. So when I had only one element, I would have 2 to the first power, and that was that equals 2, and there were two possibilities, two possible subsets. When I had an A and a B, I now have 2 elements. 2 to the second power is 4, and there were 4 possibilities. When I added the C and I had 3 elements, I have 2 to the third. 2 to the third power is 8, and there are 8 possibilities. Okay? So basically, if you want to find the number of possible subsets for a given set, all you do is take the number 2 and raise that to a power which is the same as the number of elements in that set. Okay? That's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.